Hi, it's Craig. It's an image recipe making use of our infrared image stylers. You wouldn't traditionally think that infrared is something you might use a lot for portrait, but it's got some pretty cool applications, whether you're going with the black and white or the full color, or in this case, something somewhere in between. So let's look at our starting point. And here's our image before we got started with it. And we've got our desert setting. I've got my lighting off to the side. We covered that in an earlier tutorial. And so I'm going to go in, and just because I always make use of them, we're going to do a quick treatment with the Beauty Bar Pro. We're going to take one of our lifestyle softening actions, and we'll press play. It's going through, doing its smart masking, and just doing a softening treatment to the image overall, bringing back some of the shadow detail, and just bringing in a little bit of a softer feel. And you can see in our before and after, there's our treatment through there, so just a bit of softening on that. So now we're going to go back into, and I'll walk you through the infrared, and you can see the choices that you have. And we've got different intensities of infrared. Infrared regular with its light or with the heavy. So let's go in, make use of our infrared heavy with the extra soft. And again, you've got soft or glow and a variety of other choices as well within the set. So we're going to run that, and it's going to pop up and tell me what it's going to do. It's going to create my control layers. All of these pop-ups allow you to walk through and deal with the elements of the image, because infrared is kind of a different beast. It's really cool if you can shoot it, but what's nice is that we have this choice afterwards on our image. So next step, it says that you can fine-tune how the infrared comes together. And I put in a little suggestion here. You can uncheck these steps and they'll go away, so you can run through the action quicker. So basically what the last one said was to go into my reds and yellows and play with their tonality, and I can come up with the intensity. And if I zoom in, you'll see that there's a point where I lose detail, and I can hang on to that blend of the detail and the ways that the yellow and the red come together on that. And so we'll just go through there. I'll just work with some close to the default settings on this. And we'll go down through there. Our red was a little much. We'll bring our saturation down slightly there. Press play. Carries on. You got a stage where it builds in some control layers where you can mask out some things if you want to. Then it's going to go into our softness. And all of these have their controls. So if you want to make these steps go away, just uncheck them and you'll run right through. Now we're at our Gaussian blur step, and I'm just going to keep the default setting for now. You may choose that more or less. You'll see that our next bit, we have control over the brightness. Whether we want to make use of that, we can stop and deal with that there. We can paint it out, paint it in. These instructions will walk you through and guide you through your choices as the image is produced. And our final step, just for a little more reality on the infrared, adding grain and texture to that. We'll just go with our default through there. And that's it. So our infrared, there's our starting point. There's our after. We'll do our overall through here. So we've got a really strong toned black and white. And again, we've got control over the tonality, the intents, the contrast, the level of detail. And the last thing I did, that one particular image, is, again, I just took the infrared effect and I scaled it back. There's 0. There's 100. I can bring it somewhere in between and decide, yeah, right about there. I like that. So it's got a semi-toned feel to it. It's got a undersaturated element overall. The blues are nice and dark. We got a soft, surreal feel to the desert cactus. It's just one of the many options, infinite options, that you have with the custom controls and the capabilities within the Craig's Actions at craigsactions.com. And I showed you a little bit from the Beauty Bar Pro, but also the Infrareders, a pretty cool set that allows you some pretty creative opportunities with your images, whether they're landscapes or portraits. Enjoy. Take care.